Hi everybody.
Hi.
Hi.
Thanks very much for coming on today. What I wanted to do was give everybody at our AGM a wee snippet into the life of staff at Lanarkshire Carers right now. Obviously things have changed a lot since lockdown and we're all working remotely. So I just thought we could share our experiences with everybody today. Who wants to kick us off?
I'll go first.
Great.
Initially, I thought working from home would be quite difficult for myself. However, having been provided with all the phones and laptops and all the equipment that we need to keep us in contact with people virtually, partners and carers, it's been really, really good. I've also been happy that my physical health and wellness has also been taken into consideration. I was able to source a suitable chair that met my needs. Which the organisation funded the purchase of this. So it's made a big difference to me as well, because the first few weeks was quite uncomfortable for myself. So I really appreciate that. It's also going to give all my colleagues chair envy once they see my lovely chair. Chair envy. The fact that it's been working from home and we've been able to still support the carers, it's been really, really great. We never ever thought that it would have worked the way it has. So I'm really pleased to still be able to continue in my role as carer support worker. That's me.
Brilliant. Thanks, Jackie. MDLs? Who's next?
I'll go next. sorry about that. Okay, well, I felt it was a great idea for the organisation to design a new batch of training courses, especially for online participation. We've all relied on internet connectivity to live most of our lives since March, and at least this way the carers still have the opportunity to learn, even if the face-to-face interaction isn't there. I also thought it was a nice touch to allow staff to join our weekly online yoga session, because we also need to look after our health and well-being. Luckily for us, we're a forward-thinking organisation and already had the ability to work remotely prior to lockdown, so moving to home working has been seamless. If it wasn't for our fantastic IT team, we might have taken a wee bit longer to deliver crucial services to our carers.
That's great. Thanks so much, Paul. What about volunteering, Liz? How's that changed?
Yeah, I'll go next. Well, obviously, prior to COVID, most of you know that we had redeveloped a volunteer programme and we had launched our volunteer journey diagram. And then obviously COVID struck and very quickly we had to try and adapt so that we could continue to support the existing volunteers that were wanting to still support the organisation. So we had to look at new ways of doing that. So we managed to secure some tablets which enabled our volunteers to work remotely. And it also allowed us to look at development of new volunteering roles, which meant that we could bring on board new volunteers, which has been great. We've adapted our training. Our face-to-face training is now online, which has been brilliant. The feedback that we've had from that and from the inductions that have been done online have been really, really good, really positive. From my point of view, the Teams has been amazing. Being able to talk to volunteers has been really good. Before, it was quite difficult for me to catch all the different volunteers that would be in across Lanarkshire. Now we can just get together on Teams. Peer support amongst the volunteers has grown immensely because, again, through the tablets, they're able to communicate via the team system with each other. So personally, going forward, from me, from my point of view, it's been brilliant for volunteers. I'm feeling really positive about it. So I'm
brilliant.
Excited about how things are for volunteers.
Thanks so much, Liz. And one of our newest carer support workers is Stephen. How have you experienced working from home?
Hi, I'm Stephen. Well, for me, it was, I'll admit, it was quite difficult because I started my post during lockdown, so I haven't actually met anyone face-to-face. So that's quite bizarre, but thankfully, through Teams, I've been able to meet everyone virtually. And my induction was quite unique as well, but it was great. As part of my induction, my line manager has scheduled me informal meetings with all my colleagues just to sort of get to know them, introduce myself, find out a little bit more about each other. So I do feel like I've got to know everyone a little bit better, and they all made me feel like part of the team from the beginning. And I must say thank you to my line manager also, who's been very, very supportive and checks in with me every now and again to let me know that she's there should I need help or support.
Great, thanks so much. MDLs?
I think I'll go if that's okay.
Great,
so,
yeah.
I'm Claire, and I think I wanted to acknowledge how amazing the communications has been since we've been down in lockdown. We've been using virtual platforms. A few people have mentioned it. Teams is one of the main ones that we use. And I think it's actually allowed us to communicate a lot better and more frequently than we probably did before. Our staff are spread across the whole of Lanarkshire, so we might have somebody who's perhaps in Kilsyth and someone else who's in Biggar. And physically, it's really difficult to get everybody together frequently. So this has given us a fantastic opportunity, and staff have already fed back that actually they are getting to know people better than they did before. From a management perspective, it's been great. We've been able to do support and supervision. We've been able to have staff meetings regularly. And as Stephen's just mentioned, we've brought new people in. And as Liz was saying, we've put new volunteers in. So it has been really, really good. It doesn't quite replace the cup of tea in the kitchen on your break with somebody, but it nearly does.
That's great. Thank you. And obviously one of our busiest services is our short breaks. And do you want to give us an update on that?
Yep. In addition to other funding streams we have, Short Break Bureau applied and was successful in relation to securing an emergency fund. That was via Carers Trust and the Staff Wellbeing Fund, the Scottish Wellbeing Fund. So in total, we secured £16,000. And this funding had become available to support carers who may have experienced additional difficulties or challenges during COVID-19. The Short Break Bureau, as we have always done, worked very closely with our carer support workers, who identified individual carers who would most benefit from this emergency fund. It's quite a unique fund, obviously due to the pandemic we're living through at present. In total, 61 carers benefited from that fund, which was absolutely fantastic. The feedback we had from those carers was just wonderful. The difference that it had made in a number of different ways. We funded a whole variety of things, including counselling, white goods, essential items for the home. But sort of one in a example that was, I felt was just wonderful, was a carer who was shielding with the cared for, so had very little external contact with people, was feeling quite isolated and was also quite anxious in relation to the services that had previously been in for the cared for, and that was a very high package of home care services. So we purchased an iPad, which allowed both the services for the cared for to have that professional contact with the people providing that support, and also the family support, you know, to let that person feel less anxious, a wee bit supported, and mainly not feel as isolated, was just one of the really nice stories in relation to it. And I think, you know, for the Short Break Bureau, we never possibly foreseen this coming, but to be able to provide that sort of extra bit of support was just, you know, quite rewarding, actually, that you were making a difference still to other people.
That's great. And thanks so much. That's some really brilliant outcomes being met through that service. And Smithy, you're last.
I think for me, what I'm personally proud of as an organisation is that we've supported carers right through this period of uncertainty. I feel we've all come together and adjusted to new ways of working and new technology, which has been a great learning curve for all staff and carers. What I've also noticed is more and more carers are trying some of the new online services, as well as receiving one-to-one support via the web. Now, what's really been interesting to see is carers becoming more and more comfortable with technology and apps. I've spoken with a number of carers who feel more comfortable with words such as online, apps, email, websites, who themselves are now online banking, making appointments via apps, and generally feeling comfortable with technology that they once thought was out of reach for them. So this for me has been a highlight, seeing carers moving with new ways of receiving support and trying out new technology. So to all carers, hats off to you.
Absolutely. Thanks so much, and hopefully this has given everybody an idea of how we communicate on a daily basis and just a wee snippet of how all our different services have worked since lockdown. So we all want to wave goodbye to everybody.
Bye now.
Bye.
Bye.